Okay.
Well, as you can see.
May 3rd, Floyd Money Mayweather, Marcos Maidana, Amir Khan, Luis Collazo on the undercard. What do you guys think of that fight?
That's a good, I'm intrigued by that undercard with Collazo and Amir, because Amir Khan could box really well, but Collazo, you know, look at that shot he caught, you know, Victor Ortiz with, and we all know what Amir Khan's Achilles heel is his chin, so it should be interesting to see if Amir Khan keep Collazo away for 10 to 12 rounds, whatever, or 12 rounds, I believe.
Joe
Collazo's right-handed, right?
Collazo's right-handed, and he won 7 out of his last 8.
I think he has good power.
Yeah.
Honestly, I think if you can catch him here, we'll see how Amir handles it. That was a good fight.
Yeah, but fading Julio Diaz was able to give Amir all he wanted to handle. I think Collazo, with a new found motivation and a new team behind him, it's going to be a tough fight.
But I think, just at the same token, Amir Khan's motivated, because the winner of this fight may get Floyd.
Of course.
So you have to put
him. You have the makings of a good fight because of both motivations on both sides. No one wants to go into a fight, nah, I hope I win. No, they want to go in there and hope they're going to win decisively. But with that being said, I think the momentum leans more towards Collazo's side as opposed to Amir Khan's side.
One more fight on the card. Your buddy, Carlos Molina, right here from Maywood.
Uh-huh.
You guys know him too, right, Vanes? You know? He might be fighting Adrian Broner.
Yeah, to me, I wish Carlos Molina all the best. He's a good fighter. You know, last outing was quite some time ago against Amir Khan, and he fought a tough, valiant fight, but they obviously stopped it for good reason. And if that's the fight Adrian Broner takes, then we'll see what Adrian Broner does. You know? But let him know he's fighting the wrong Molina, because this Molina is the one that wanted him.
Maybe it could happen in the future.
We'll see. I got my work cut out for me coming pretty soon.
Hey, have you guys sparred yet?
Look at his eye. What do you think? Come on. Who do you think did that to him?
John has power.
Yeah, we've never sparred in all the years that we've known him. As a matter of fact, he was at my first amateur fight when we first met. And all he can tell me is, throw your damn right hand! A long time ago, but I remember that.
You don't have to tell you that anymore.
So, that was, yeah, he was there on my first amateur fight in Ballin Park.
Vanes, who have you sparred in the last few years from the big names? Chavez Jr.?
Roman Karmazan, Chavez Jr., Kingsley Aikiki, Bernard Hopkins.
You sparred Hopkins? What was that like?
Great.
How did that come about?
It was good. He's been waiting for a Winky, right? He sparred. So many guys. A lot of undefeated kids, up and comers, prospects. I don't know a lot.
Gennady Golovkin ever sparred him?
No.
If he fights Chavez Jr., who wins?
Gennady Golovkin.
That's a good fight, though. It's entertaining, because the one thing you say about Chavez Jr., you can say a lot of bad things, but he's always in an entertaining fight, no matter what it is. And even with Sergio Martinez, you know, he even made that last round very
entertaining.
It was
entertaining to the last round.
So.
Yeah, that was the only entertaining part.
All I'm saying is his style is fan-friendly.
The buzz wore off.
Yeah, wow, what's wrong with you?
The buzz.
So there you have it, Joe. Another day at the office?
Yeah, another day at the office. LA.
There you have it. And I'm not high. I have allergies. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm really sick. I'm reporting. People think I'm high, but I...